Ladies and gentlemen, we are at an exhibition, Art for the Cause of Animals, brought to you by Vrinda Agarwal. This is a seventh edition of Young Expression. We are at the Makanis Palace Exhibition Center, and we have wonderful pictures exhibited here. It's very interesting to know that we have Vrinda Agarwal right with us along with all her students. We would like to have a small explanation of this wonderful exhibition from Vrinda. Vrinda, could you please tell us what is this exhibition all about?
It's an exhibition where I display the artworks of all my students, and basically we work on a cause. Like this time we are working for animals, so basically to tell them how important animals are for our environment. So that's how, like, when we are working together, we learn how to work in a team and we discuss a lot of stuff. So I hope my kids are now aware of why animals are important. All together, I mean, also to train them to help animals who are in distress.
All right. You know, as per what I got the information, Vrinda trains very young minds. They are mostly from school. They're mostly from school. They attend their classes, and in the afternoon, once in a week, 1.5 hours they spend with Vrinda. Vrinda has been instrumental in triggering the skill that is within oneself. She told me it's not because children have to draw diagrams for biology class that they need to learn to draw, but that is much more than that. And to know what exactly is in the mind of the trainer to train such young minds, let us have a view with her. So, Vrinda, this is you teach them how to draw. Right from the beginning, even a new child who has never drawn before comes to you, you give him the simplest thing. But I'm sure there is more than that of the drawing. Can you please explain to us?
Yeah, when a child comes to me, it's not necessary that they know how to draw. But I think, I feel that it's all in the mind. So I work on their confidence levels first. I give them very easy pictures to work on. Once they are confident enough, I start increasing the difficulty level. And then from there, it's never ending. They do a lot of work for me. Also, I build up my friendship with them first. So once we are friends, then it's all done. They do anything for me. And
okay.
You can see the works around. They are amazing. You will not feel that it's been done by children. In fact, they are so artistic. They are like true artists. For me, that's the reason I call them young artists. Even on my post and everywhere, you'll find it. It's seventh Young Expressions. As my exhibitions goes by the names of expressions, their exhibition goes by Young Expressions because they are the youngsters. They are the kids.
That's so so true. And if you see at this picture, some of them, this look very professional. The color combinations that I used, the pencil sketches that I used. But more than that, when a young child, a budding child who is looking into life, starts drawing, how does he look at life? What are the aspects that trigger within him?
See, when we become friends, they come up with a lot of stuff. It's not only about art. We talk about life in general. It's like they have problems in the school, they have problems with the friends, or they have any crushes like girls do, and a lot of other things. So we basically work in a team. We talk about everything, and at the same time we work on the artworks. And when they're happy, when they feel okay, their problems are sorted, they're happy. And when they're happy, these are the results. So the artworks that come out also, they're all happy. So when you look at them, you feel happy. So it's basically, we are like one team working together to everything. It's not only animals, but towards like traffic, as I was telling you before. It's like they're not aware of traffic rules and all stuff. They just have competitions, they go for competitions, they want to win a competition. No, parents need to sit and tell them what is it about, how to keep yourself safe and follow those rules. So from my side, as a teacher, what I teach, I follow. If I'm wearing a helmet, obviously my children will also wear a helmet. But if I don't, they will not.
Well, therefore, this training of young minds of the art also makes them realize many aspects of life and why they're happening. You see, I've been observing that here there are many young students from school level, but I have also seen some grown-up girls and boys who are also there. How is that they are also with you?
They are from the beginning with me, since they were like 3 or 4 years old. So they have continued with the classes till today. So they're like, in a way, they've become my own kids because I've seen them growing till college. So that's how they are with me still.
And they continue.
They continue. There is a girl who's in second year college and still she's continuing.
Okay, she loves to do this. And
like once in a week we meet up, we share everything. She also shares her problems and you always need a friend. Anybody in this world, everybody needs a friend.
Very true.
And when they see a friend in me, they do come. And not only art, at the same time, she can share her problems or we can share some happy moments and we can discuss stuff and deal with life in a more better way.
It is not necessary that once one learns this art, that one has to plunge into fine arts or anything of that sort. But nevertheless, is there any percentage of your students who have gone into getting this foundation of arts and then plunging into fine arts and all?
Very few. Yes, they have got into like automobile designing, they've got into architecture, but fine arts, very few kids. But we don't go by, okay, you have to take it as a profession. When I'm training them, it's not about they are going to become a fine artist. It's about having that place in your life for art, which can keep them at peace, at the same time, release them with all the stress and keep them happy and going. That's very important.
Yeah, I have seen some of your pictures. There is some price put them on them for sale. Exactly how do we judge as to how much is the price of a picture and what happens with the money that comes for it?
Okay, so now the aim of pricing them and selling them was not to get money. It was about when we sell them, we've kept them at a very reasonable cost so that people can buy. And when people buy, so we can donate some amount to an animal shelter. This teaches them that even when they grow up and they get a salary or they earn anything, they can share a percentage of it, maybe 10%, maybe 1%, whatever they feel like. But they need to share a part of their income with others. They should not keep everything for themselves. That's not how life is. If you really want to live your life, learn to share, learn to give. That's more important. I don't keep everything to myself. I try and teach everything to my students, whatever I know.
That's a wonderful message that Vrinda Agarwal has given as a teacher, training young minds, that we need to share with others what we get. God has blessed us with a lot of talents. We can be blessed with a lot of wealth, but that is not meant only for us, but to be shared with others. Thank you very much, Vrinda, for this wonderful opportunity that you have given us to talk to you, to express your ideas through young minds.
My name is Benjamin Nathaniel D'Souza and I am a student of Vrinda Agarwal and I am taking part in this glorious exhibition and I have done this one, as you can see, Jesus Christ with thorns on his head. It's done with charcoal. And then my next one is a war machine, Avengers. It is from the Infinity War, just before the end game. And this dog also I have done, it is from oil pistols, it is for sale. And I at least took half a month to do this. Thank you.
For the young people, it's very important to get a lesson that nowadays children are too busy wasting their time on their mobile and TV and the internet, but they do not put their time as and convert them into value. So this is one of the best ways to train your mind, which will prepare you wholesome. Thank you very much all being here. Thank you, Vrinda. Thank you, CCR TV.